The idea for this video was simple: show the movements of CrossFit without putting the focus on any particular athlete. Beforehand, I had created a motion graphics piece for CrossFit 508, but was unaware that people featured in the images were no longer affiliated with that box. Additionally, I had seen a Reebok CrossFit commercial that featured elite physical specimens performing different activities. By seeing their faces, I, as the viewer, cannot imagine myself doing those movements. To convince someone to try CrossFit, he or she needs to imagine doing each activity personally. This is the goal I kept in mind when building the storyboards. After speaking with Dawn Marie Angus about which CrossFit actions were necessary to showcase, I created a simple paper storyboard to illustrate the camera framing. I additionally built an animatic to demonstrate the pacing and feel of the commercial. It was at this point that I wanted to bring in an audio designer. I encouraged Dawn Marie that Levi Shutt be contracted for his skills and services. The date of the video shoot was set and a sign-up sheet was posted for volunteers, both to be featured in the video and for behind-the-scenes production. Two segments of the video required camera tracking back through the athlete crowd. To better perform this task, I needed a fig rig. I sought out a friend, Dan Murray, to help me with this. I'm good at some things, but mechanical construction ability is not currently one of them. By doing my due diligence, I learned that some shots would have to be rethought. This was information that I needed to know and not discover come the day of the shoot. The day of the CrossFit 508 video shoot went smoothly. As I mentioned to Dawn Marie, it was the best video shoot experience I had ever had. The athletes were ready and willing to perform in front of the camera. Each shot was captured in order of difficulty and lighting. The most difficult shot for me was the handstand push-up. With the help of the production team, I was perched about 8 feet above the ground with a camera capturing each rep. Did I mention I hate heights? Fortunately, Jeff Boardman and Dan Murray were perched alongside me both to give direction and keep me from freaking out. Next, filming the camera tracking segments involved using my T3i camera, the fig rig, a rolling office chair, and Amanda Burns, a volunteer cameraman. She held the fig rig setup while I steadily pulled the chair back through the organized athletes. While shooting, it is necessary to be adaptable. I had originally planned to have the members of CrossFit 508 stand in formation. It was Dawn Marie's brilliant idea to have them perform PVC warm-up drills. I'm glad this sequence was altered. Post-production started with reviewing all the video footage. 10 gigabytes of video, and I'm happy to say that only 3% made it to the cutting room floor. The idea of interchanging the athletes during the video was, in fact, not a part of the initial storyboard. This idea came while scouting the location and prepping for the video shoot. It was at this time I recommended to Dawn Marie that a 90-second video be made in addition to the 60-second cut. Levi designed the audio files accordingly. With all the footage that was collected, I didn't want any of it to go to waste. Stabilizing the video footage was long and grueling. This required multiple tracking passes and render outputs through Adobe After Effects. Next, I built a rough edit synchronized to those audio tracks. A personal note about contracting others. I don't like using royalty-free music sites. Yes, I understand that's a viable option. However, if I need to make changes to audio, I am limited in my ability and knowledge to do so. This is why I prefer to work with others whose skill can complement my own. I trusted Levi to diligently design audio for this project, and will do so again if another requiring his skill comes my way. I designed the captions and title sequences after the audio rough cut. The logo was created in Adobe Illustrator and converted to masked layers in After Effects. The captions were difficult as I wanted to create something that was visually similar but didn't draw attention away. I'm happy with the result and believe that the logo animation grabs the viewer's attention at the finale. I color corrected and color treated the video footage before rendering the alpha build. Balancing the color palette of the video footage, both inside and outside, still leaves room for improvement. However, I believe myself capable of mastering this skill in the near future. The final video was shown to an attentive crowd at a CrossFit 508 social gathering. I have always been my own worst critic. I enjoy my work in digital media, but shy away from any attention it may shine. Dawn Marie and the athletes of CrossFit 508 were excited by the video's outcome. I am thankful for the success of this production and look forward to similar ones to follow.